Welcome students, welcome to TS classes. In the last two video, we have studied about simple interest. In this class, we will study about compound interest. Let's start our class. Compound interest, which is the most important subject for any type of examination. Compound interest question, most probably in the examination, the students try to skip this question because the process is very long. But I will elaborate today the short tricks. Before going to the short tricks, first we will study what is compound interest and its general process with formula. So, what is compound interest? It is different from the simple interest that in simple interest, every year the principal value is constant and the instant interest is also constant for every year. But compound interest, the principal value is updated every year annually. That means if first year the principal amount is 100 and the rate of interest is 10%, then the next year the annual value will be 110, because 10% interest, 10% interest means from 100 rupees 10% is equal to 10 rupees. So 100 plus 10 is equal to 110. In the next year, the same 100 rupees will be the principal value for the simple interest. If we calculate in the compound interest, then that 110 rupees, which was the total amount for the after first year, that will becomes the principal value for the second year. And from this 110, the next 10% value will be calculated. That means for the second year, the simple interest, if we calculated, is equal to the simple interest of the first year. But in case of compound year, this interest for the first year, which is equal to the simple interest. But in case of compound interest, the interest in the second year will be more than the simple interest. So let's go for the formula. Now, in compound interest, the formula, the general formula is F is equal to P whole into 1 plus R by 100 to the power of T. Here P is the principal value, which can I can take it is the also present value. F is the future value, that means which is the annual amount, which is the amount in the further. Next, R is equal to the rate of interest and T is equal to time. So F is equal to future value, P is equal to present value, R is equal to rate of interest and T is equal to time. Here we have to remember the principal keeps updating annually. We have already said, that the principal value is keeps updating annually in case of compound interest. But in case of simple interest, the principal value does not change. It is always constant for every year. Next, the interest is also updating in every year. Interest is also updating annually. That means in compound interest, the principal and interest both are updated after the end of the year. But in simple interest, the principal and interest both are fixed. That will not change after any year. And the one difference thing is, the compound interest is always more than the simple interest when the time is greater than 1 year. For the first year, the simple interest and the compound interest both are equal. But for the second year, the simple interest is same as the first year for simple interest. But in case of compound interest, the interest is more than the first year. This is the basics. Now we will study how we will solve this question by our tricks. There are several types of tricks in compound interest. I will teach you two or three tricks by which we can solve this type of question very easily. Let's study about the tricks. Let us do the compound interest problem with an example. The first question is, what will be the total value after 3 years of the principal value is 1000 rupees and the rate of interest is 20% and the time is 3 years. In this question, the principal value is given, the rate of interest is given and the time is given, and the what will be the future value is asked to us. First, we will try to solve this question in general process. Here, the principal value P is equal to 1000 rupees. Next, the rate of interest R is equal to 20% and time T is equal to 3 years. So here it is asked what is the future value. So we know the formula F, which is equal to P whole into 1 plus R by 100 to the power of T. that means 1000 whole into 1 plus 20 by 100 to the power of 3. So, if we try to solve this question, then we have to find out here 1000 whole into 120 by 100 power 3. If I simplify this, I can get 1000 whole into 6 by 5 power cube. So, in every type of question, we have to find out the cube of any types of number. Here it is 6 by 5, we can calculate it. But if it was 13, it was 25, it was 36, then we cannot solve such type of problem. That will be very difficult to us to finding the cube of any number. So, in that case, to simplify such type of question, we have to follow some tricks. What the tricks we have to do? I will teach here three types of tricks. The first trick will be tabulation method, next is the successive method, and third is the future value method. I will elaborate all the three tricks one by one in this question. Let's do the tricks. In tabulation method, the first here, what we have to write? Here I have to write the, what is the 20% of 1000. The 20% of 1000 is 200. So here I will write simply 200 is here. So faster work is finished. For the second year, I have to write this 200. Just copy it to here. So 200 will be here. And next, I have to find the 20% of the 200. So 20% of 200 is 40. So I will write 40 here. So 200 plus 40 is equal to 240. So in third year, this 240 will be written to here. That means it is written 240 here. And next, the 20% of 240, which is equal to 48. So I will write here 288. So these three are the interest for the first year, second year, and third year. So the total interest will be 200 plus 240 plus 288 is 728. This is only the interest part for the 3 years. So the future value will be 1000 plus 728. So future value will be 1728. This is the easiest way to find the compound interest for 3 years. Next we will go for successive method. In successive method, first we have to check what is the rate of interest, which is equal to 20%. 20% means it is 1 by 5. In 1 by 5, we have to check the upper part is the interest, which is I is equal to 1, and the lower part is the principal value, which is equal to 5. So, what will be the future value? The future value will be 6 is here, because 5 plus 1 is equal to 6 here. So now, we have to check how many years it is given. It is given for 3 years. So for 3 years, I have to multiply these things. That means 5 into 5 into 5, which is equal to 125. Similarly, the 6 we have to multiply for 3 times. That will be 6 into 6 into 6, which is equal to 260. Now, I have to check the principal value is 125 times and the principal value is 1000 rupees. So, I have to compare this 125 times is equal to 1000 rupees. And I have to find out what is the 216 times. So, 216 times will be 1000 divided by 125 into 216. Here, the value will be 1728 rupees. If in this process we have to find what is the interest part, then it is the principal value is 125 times and the future value is 216 times. If I do minus, then the interest part will be 216 minus 125 is equal to 91 times. And now we can find that 125 times is equal to 1000 rupees. Then the 91 times is equal to this one, 1000 divided by 125 into 91, which is equal to 728 rupees. This is the successive method. Next, I will go for the future value process. This process is very easy. And the process we can find it, R is equal to 20%. Here, R is given, which is the 20%. 20% means it is 1 by 5. So, in 1 by 5, I have to do plus 1. So, 1 by 5 plus 1 is equal to 6 by 5. This is the most important factor. What we have to do? 6/5 and the time is for 3 years. So the future value will be, the principal amount given is 1000 into this time I have to multiply for number of year times, it is 3 times, so it is 6/5 into 6/5 into 6/5 and the answer is equal to 1728 rupees. So here I have described 3 different processes. The process which will be easy to you, you can do in the examination. So any type of question from compound interest you can take and try to solve it. This make these 3 cases you can get easily. So next we go for another question. Let's go for the next question, and this question is, what is the total value for 4 years with 25% rate of compound interest if the principal value is 32,000? Here what is given to us? Here it is given, the principal value is 32,000. The time is given here 4 years and the rate of interest is 25%. So I will solve this question in 2 processes. The first process is tabulation method. In tabulation method we have to do 4 column because 4 year it is given. So it is year 1, year 2, year 3 and year 4. So the first year, the 25% of 32,000. 28% of 32,000 will be 8,000 rupees. So 8,000 is written here. For the next year, this 8,000 will be written. And I have to do the 25% of 8,000. So 25% of 8,000 is 2,000. So if I add this 2, I can get it is 10,000. Next, the 10,000 will be written here and 25% of 10,000 is 2,500. If I add this 2, I can get it is 12,500. And now this 12,000 rupees is given to the fourth year, so 12,500 rupees, and the 25% of 12,500 is 3,125 rupees. If I add this 2, I can get it is 15,625. So here the first year interest is 8,000, second year is 10,000, third year is 12,500 and fourth year is 15,625. Then what is the total interest in 4 years? So the total interest will be addition of these 4 and the answer is 46,125 rupees. Next, what is the future value? The future value means I have to add this 32,000 rupees with 46,125. So 46,125 plus 32,000 is equal to 78,125 rupees. This is the process in tabular method, but in future value method it will be very easy. So the answer will be, I have to multiply 4 times because 4 year is given, 4 times this rate of interest. So rate of interest is equal to 25%. 28% means it is 1/4. So 1/4 means I have to add plus 1 here. So 1/4 plus 1 is equal to, which is 5/4. So this 5/4 I have to multiply 4 times with this principal value. So 32,000 into 5/4 into 5/4 into 5/4 into 5/4, and the answer is 78,125 rupees. This is the future value after 4 years. If we want to interest, then the interest which is value, the difference between the future value and present value, which is equal to 78,125 minus 32,000. So the interest is equal to 46,125 rupees. In this class, we have studied the process, 2 or 3 tricks, how to calculate this compound interest. In the next class, we will do another example of compound interest. Thank you.